Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at the North American stock markets for Wednesday morning. We're coming up to 7 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures are above fair value. Today is a Fed day, so there should be a bullish tone to the day until 2 p.m. It's an unusual Fed day because there's actually no press conference this afternoon, so we're just getting the minutes released, and then the market will react to that after 2 p.m. this afternoon. Just a little public service announcement before we get started this morning. I am off to donate blood this morning, and while that's a good thing, there's a blood shortage most of the year, but especially during the summertime with everybody out playing and being a lot more active. Donating blood is actually really good for your health. It forces your body to create new blood to replace the blood you've donated. And of course, new blood is better than old blood. So if you have any concerns about your health, and you're healthy enough to donate blood, it is something you should consider doing on a regular basis. Now back to our regularly scheduled program, and first up this morning, let's take a look at Twitter. Twitter's been dead money for a couple of months now after breaking down. We've been trading in a range, so we've been looking for a breakout above 37.50 or a breakdown below 34.38. Yesterday, we actually ended the day on a positive note going into the earnings announcement, looking for a close above 36.37. We actually got that, a close above up there at 36.54. So technically, we have a buy signal, but now you come into this morning and you check on Twitter and find out that it's down over 11%. Now, it was up about 11% after the announcement came out, so it's been all over the place. Since the announcement, the earnings announcement came out. So there's no reason to be buying a Twitter on Wednesday. We are actually trading below the 34.38 level, so we're breaking down as opposed to breaking out. So if you've been, if you want to buy Twitter, then just sit on your hands and wait for the next confirmation, the next close above the upper channel line. And I don't think that's going to happen on Wednesday. Looking at the markets, we saw bonds pull back a little yesterday in the U.S. and in Canada, traded back in the channel, but we're still on a buy signal here. Looking at currencies, an inside day for the U.S. dollar, inside day for the euro, little tiny, tiny little bit of strength for the Canadian dollar. Certainly no change in direction there. The VIX came down hard yesterday, still on a buy signal, so we're looking for a close below 1297 on Wednesday to give us a sell signal. And for the VIX for the NASDAQ, we're looking for a close below 1444. Now, we saw more strength in the Dow and the S&P 500 yesterday than we did the NASDAQ. There's the S&P 500 trading up into the channel. So first sign something new is happening, of course, is going to be a close above Friday's high. That's where we saw all the downward pressure and then follow through to the downside on Monday. That would be the first sign something new is happening. For the NASDAQ, we didn't drop as much, not as much strength yesterday. And one of the reasons was that we saw strength in the energy sector yesterday, and that certainly helped the Dow put up some points. So a close above 46.02 would give us a buy signal for the NASDAQ on Wednesday. There's the TSX making a new low yesterday. There's the U.S. banking sector inside day on Tuesday. Canadian banks closed a little higher but didn't take out the previous day's high. We've got an open gap there for the market to deal with. There's the strength in the U.S. energy sector. Two stocks in the Dow certainly added a bunch of points for the Dow on Tuesday. There's the Canadian energy sector up yesterday, not as much as in the U.S. Inside day for the XAU, inside day for the TSX Gold Index, and gold itself had an inside day on Tuesday. There is the semiconductors trading up to the lower channel line. There is the transports having a big up day yesterday, back on a buy signal. That had a lot to do with air freight, and air freight had a lot to do with UPS. We also saw some strength in the railroads, not enough to give us a buy signal. We certainly got a buy signal for Kansas City and a big up day for Union Pacific, still looking for a close above 97.05. And we had a nice update for Canadian National, still on a buy signal, still up at the top of the trading range. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices, and our commodity tracking ETF was up slightly. That had a lot to do with crude oil being up slightly. Gasoline continued lower. We saw natural gas move up closing at the lower channel line. There's our base metal ETF trading up yesterday. That had a lot to do with the price of copper, had nothing to do with the price of gold. Inside day for gold, inside day for platinum, and an inside day for silver. So no change for the metals on Tuesday. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. There's the VIX, and the VIX came down yesterday, which of course is supportive for higher stock prices. An hourly close above 1469 would give us a new buy signal on Wednesday. That would be negative for stocks. If that were to happen, you'd probably have the S&P 500 down below 2079.01. That would generate a new intraday sell signal. Yesterday at this time, we were looking up to 2078. That was our first target. We drove through that and continued higher up to 2093.75. If we're going to continue higher on Wednesday, then 2109.38 would be our next mathematical target. We did run into moving average resistance yesterday, so where all the moving averages are converging, that's where we stopped yesterday, still projecting higher prices. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, we're coming into Wednesday on an intraday buy signal. That would change with an hourly close below 4533.54. And for the XAU, we treaded water yesterday. An hourly close above 47.85 would give us a new intraday buy signal. And you can see that we're still well below the hourly flypaper channel. We would need to move up above the flypaper channel, and I'd certainly look for a move up above this open gap. If that were to happen, that's where you would see daily buy signals show up for some of the major stocks. And I would certainly be talking a lot more about this sector if that were to happen. It certainly doesn't look like it's going to happen on Wednesday. And last up this morning, a quick look at the TSX. The TSX is back on an intraday buy signal, but barely. Things would change on Wednesday with an hourly close below 14,025. And of course, we're looking for support at the 14,000 level to hold once again. We did trade through that the other day, but came back and closed right at the 14,000 level. You can see while we were up yesterday and the chart started to turn blue, the pros are still not in control intraday. And so I'm not too enthusiastic about the Canadian stock market on Wednesday. There's a projection up to the nearly 50-hour moving average and then a breakdown from there. So there is a chance for a move up. There's certainly a chance to move up and fill that open gap. But we're not looking for a lot on the upside for the Canadian stock market on Wednesday. Okay, folks, that is all for this presentation, but I will be back later this morning to look at the 10 most actively traded stocks on the New York Stock Exchange from Tuesday's trading action. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.